Hi, I'm Greg Tran, Gregory Group Real Estate here in Austin, Texas. Thanks for joining me again. This is part two of our first time home buyer questions and answers. And of course, just like the first part, they are in no particular order. But if you haven't seen the first part yet, you may want to go check that out. Also, if you'd like more in-depth answers to your questions here or want to see really how the whole home buying process works, go to ggre.co/firsthome. And get your name on the list so we can notify you when we do our next live Q&A session for first-time home buyers. Here's the first question. Should I buy a resale home, which means a used home, or should I buy a new construction? So there's a couple things to think about here. Of course, the first one is, which one do you want? Some people really like being in a new home. They like knowing that everything is fresh, new, has warranties, and that they're the first people who have ever lived in it. If that's you, then it's a pretty easy decision. Other people, of course, like homes that are older, more established neighborhoods. And of course, for them, the resale is going to be the better option. A couple of other factors to consider. Right now, our market is pretty hot, which means that on the buyer side, we may come up against a lot of multiple offers, which can make the offer process a little tougher. And this can happen in resale properties. So if you don't want to take part in any of that, having bidding wars, anything like that, sometimes new construction is just an easier option. Now for resale, there's a lot of benefits too. First of all, there's just much more to pick from. You can pick from homes that are 5 years old, 10 years old, all the way up to 100-year-old homes. You know, it really depends on what it is you like. And a lot of times, if you want certain locations, the only things that are available there are mostly resale homes, unless you're lucky and you find a new construction home that was built where an old home coming tore down. Next question, what's a MUD? So MUD is short for Municipal Utility District, or they're also sometimes called Public Utility Districts. And most of the times you're gonna find these in newer neighborhoods, because when they build a new neighborhood, there's a certain amount that someone has to pay to run all the electric and water and that type of thing out there. And because of that, they have the homeowners pay these as part of their taxes for quite a while. So because of that, your taxes are going to be higher if you live in one of these MUD districts. What appliances come with the house? Anything attached to the home comes with the home. And I'm not just talking appliances. If you walk into a home and you see it has blinds or window coverings, ceiling fans, anything like that, if it's attached, if you need a tool to take it off, then it's supposed to come with the home by default. In terms of appliances, the range is always included. The microwave, if it's one of those attached ones, like a microwave hood, that's going to be included. The dishwasher, all of those are by default included with the home. The refrigerator, washer, dryer, those are not included. A lot of times you can ask for that and you can get that, but understand that if you don't ask for it, you may not get that. How do I know if anything is wrong with the house I'm buying? It's a great question. So whether you're getting a resale or a new construction home, we always recommend to use a licensed inspector. What the inspector does is they go in and they take a look at all the major systems of the home. You know, that can be the roof, plumbing, air conditioning, all of these things, and they'll test all of it and make sure all of it works. Understand that they can't see inside the walls, but a lot of times if there is some kind of issue with something in the walls, there are signs that you can see that can point that out. Also know that an inspector's job is really to note almost every little thing they can find. So a lot of it is going to be a little nitpicky, especially if you're looking at a resale house. A lot of the stuff they're pointing out might be cosmetic and really not that big of a deal, because you understand that you're not buying a brand new home, but they will be able to point out a lot of the important things for you. Oh, related question, how much does an inspection cost? So usually it costs between $350 to $450, depending on the exact services they offer. If you want a pest inspection, like for termites, that's usually gonna cost a little bit extra because they'll have an actual licensed pest inspector come out. Do I actually need to get a title policy? A lot of buyers look at the closing statement and they see a couple thousand dollars for title policy and they ask, do I really need this? And here's the answer. If you're getting a loan on the house, then yes, you have to get a title policy. The good thing is most of the time your real estate agent can negotiate that the seller pays for that title policy, so it's covered for you already. What does the title policy do? The title policy covers you for anything that can be strange with a chain of title. You know, they call it clouds, but the title company goes back and makes sure that the person who is selling you the house actually owns the house. Also, they're gonna check and make sure that there aren't any liens against the home. liens being, say, the owner owes $50,000 to the IRS. They will find those things and make sure that the seller pays those off when you close so that you don't have to take care of that when you own the home. Are earnest money and option money two separate checks? Yes, because they pay for two different things. First of all, the option check goes to the seller. And what that does is it gives you that right. Most of the time, it's between 5 to 7 days. And we also call this a due diligence period. But this is a time when you're going to have an inspector come out, take a look and see if anything needs repairs. And if so, you can negotiate it in that period. And if it doesn't work out, then you can back out during that time. Earnest money is about 1% of the purchase price. $400,000 home, $4,000. And this money gets, the check does get cashed because people do ask me that. But the check gets cashed and it sits in escrow. So it's in the third party at the title company. And it sits there until either the home closes or the contract gets terminated. Do I need homeowners insurance? Absolutely, you need homeowners insurance. If you're getting a loan on the home, then it's mandatory. They will not give you a loan without there being homeowners insurance. However, even if you paid for it in cash, you still should have it because it's such a small price to pay in case something bad happens, like an electrical fire or a big hurricane comes or something like that. It's insurance. It's a small price to pay and it's just something you don't want to be without when something goes wrong. How much does insurance cost? This I really have to refer you to insurance partners. It depends on so many different things. First of all, how much would the house cost to rebuild? A $200,000 house is going to cost very different from a $800,000 house. Also, it depends on different things like your credit. If your credit is better, sometimes you can get a better insurance rate than someone whose credit is not as good. So once again, I'd refer you to one of our insurance partners to get a quote and you can see better how that looks. Last question. Why are the sellers asking for so much more than the tax appraisal value? It's a great question and one that so many people ask. Understand that market value and the tax appraisal value are two completely different things. They're somewhat related, but really they are not a good indicator of each other. Tax appraisals, what they do is called blanket appraisals. So they'll take a whole neighborhood or a whole section and they'll basically assign it a dollar value, a dollar per square foot value. And depending on how big it is, what the land is like, this is all done electronically and they assign everything a value. The reason it's different from market value is market value really is what a buyer is willing to pay for the home and a seller is willing to accept it at. So this changes very quickly and it's very different from house to house. You know that if you walk into one house that's 2,000 square feet, 3-2 on a green belt, you can walk into a house next door and have the exact same stats, but those two houses can feel completely different and to you have a completely different value. You can see that as the buyer. However, the taxing authorities just don't know this kind of thing. And that's one good reason why the tax value has really nothing to do with the market value. Thank you for taking the time to watch this video and see some of the answers we have to first-time home buyer questions. If you didn't catch it earlier, you can sign up to get on the wait list for our upcoming live first-time home buyer Q&A sessions. And all you need to do is go to ggre.co/firsthome and put your name on the list and we'll make sure to get you an invite to the next session. If you have any other questions, feel free to email me or just reach out to me or the team and let's get them answered for you.